What's up, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Dan here. Hope you are well. Today we are chatting everything deloads. What is a deload week? Do you actually even need to implement one? And if you do, how do you implement a deload? Like the video, subscribe for more content, roll the intro, let's get into it. So you're aching, you're mentally fatigued, you're physically fatigued, your performance has started slacking in the gym, the weights are going down over a couple of weeks. Sound familiar? If this is you, I think we've all been there at some point, it may be a good idea to take a step back and implement a deload week, or just take a break from the gym altogether. So what is a deload week? A deload is either a reduction in volume or a reduction in intensity of your training in order for you to allow yourself and your body to recover from high intensity training. It can be beneficial in terms of breaking a plateau. So if you find that you are struggling over a couple of weeks and the weights are actually coming down, it may be a good idea to implement it. It can help break strength plateaus or just general mental and physical fatigue in the gym. Improve motivation, because by giving yourself a break and some time off, you're going to probably be more motivated when you step back into the gym. And ultimately, we are trying to set ourselves up for long-term adherence and enjoyment of our training. It can also be really beneficial to prevent injuries long-term. If you are consistently training at really high intensity without a break ever, at some point you are likely to run into an injury. So it can be really beneficial from all of these aspects. Do I need a deload? This is a common question asked. People are not sure whether they should implement or not. This is my suggestion. Don't take it as gospel, but as a general rule of thumb, I personally think that if you are training at a very high intensity, so an RPE, rate of perceived exertion, out of 10, where 10 is maximum absolute muscular failure, can't get another rep out. If you're training RPE of an 8 to 10, 8, 9, 10 out of 10, in high intensity, at some point you probably will need a deload of some sort. If you're training at a slightly lower intensity, doing more like 3 or 4 sets per exercise at about an RPE of 7 out of 10, you may feel that you don't actually ever really need a full deload week. You may just want to take the odd day, the rest days here and there, and maybe just take a bit of time out of training when you're on holiday and things like that. So if you're training at a very high intensity, 8 to 9, 10 out of 10 and on the RPE scale, I definitely think there can be some benefits to taking a deload week. If you're working out a intensity of 7 out of 10 and with slightly higher volume, and that's your preferred method of training, then probably may not be necessary a full deload week. I wouldn't recommend going below a 7 out of 10 in terms of intensity in your training, because you're probably not providing the stimulus required for muscle growth. If you're anything around a 5 or 6 out of 10 in terms of effort, we need high training intensity to make gains. So now we've identified if you need a deload week, how do we actually go about it? How do we implement it? Well, there's three main school of thoughts actually. The first one is a D volume. So let's say that you are taking most of your sets quite close to failure and you're lifting heavy weights. You can just reduce the sets generally by about 50%. So if you normally perform 3 sets, perform 2 or perform 1. If you perform 4 sets, drop it the volume to 2 sets of every exercise. Keep the weights as they were, same weights used, but just bring that volume down, and that's going to release a bit of pressure on the body. Similarly, the other way that you can go about it is just a deload on the intensity. So reduce the weights used to about 50 to 60% of your one rep max, perform the same amount of volume. That's the other way. The most simple way of implementing a deload is literally to take a complete break from the gym. Maybe you just want to take 3, 4, 5 days off the gym, clear your head and step back into the gym after a break. Having a week off the gym in the grand scheme of things, if you are consistent in turning up every week over a long period of time, 1 week off is not going to make any significant difference. It's not going to cause muscle atrophy where you start losing muscle size and losing all of your gains. It's not going to happen within a week. It's going to take at least a few weeks for any of this to occur. So don't worry if you are feeling very fatigued, and the simplest way for you is just to time it around a holiday and take a complete break from the gym, then that is absolutely fine too. How long should a deload last? Well, it's completely up to you. Generally for most people it is a week of training where they just drop the volume or the intensity and still go to the gym. You could even take a week off. Be guided with how your body feels. You may only need a couple of days to reduce the volume or the intensity and then to step back in with a fresh motivation. This is the main thing. One of the main benefits of a deload should be that you should come back in fully motivated, ready to train with appropriate intensity and enjoy your next block of training. So whatever you do in terms of taking a break from training, make sure that you come in with a great mindset when you return to the gym. I really hope you found this video useful. That's it for today's video. Like the video, leave me a comment, subscribe for more content, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Catch you in a bit. See you later. Bye.